Have a few extra cards lying around? Looking to turn your rotating staples into a Theros booster box? Check out Channel Fireball's online buy list. We offer the most competitive prices on all of your unwanted cards, and we send payments fast via check or PayPal. If you're not looking for cash, we offer a hefty 30% store credit bonus. Head to channelfireball.com/buylist to submit your buy order. It's fast, it's easy, and as LSV would say, it's good value.
Hey everyone, welcome to a cube draft. We have a few good cards in the pack. Armageddon is one of them, definitely a powerful white card that you really want in most aggressive weenie decks. Those are the type of cards that are going to end up winning a lot of the games. Whereas something like Student of Warfare, you can sort of replace pretty easily. I mean, you can see like Comedy of Ancient Law, all that's nonsense. We also have Seagate Oracle, generally good in the like value blue decks. Just usually being able to give you card selection, a body that can block. Alternatively, we have Entreat the Angel, which is pretty good with Mystical Tutor, Sensei Divine Tap, that sort of stuff. Go for the Throat, Kaiga. But overall, I prefer Armageddon just because it seems like the most powerful card, whereas something like Kaiga is just sort of very replaceable. So we're going to take the Armageddon and look for maybe a white weenie deck if it's open. Now, looking in this pack, we've got Pure Dame, which is pretty good. Survival of the Fittest is also pretty good. Survival is generally good in reanimator decks, and then mono green decks where you have a lot of one drops where you end up sort of losing the value of those early drops later on in the game, and then so you can use survival to change those into your finishing creatures like Avenger of Zendikar and Sundering Titan and that sort of stuff. Overall, this pack's pretty weak. I think it's really between Preordain and Survival of the Fittest. And I'm generally more of a fan of Survival, just because, like I said, it's a bit more powerful. I mean, Preordain is good if you have good cards to draw into, but Survival is definitely something you can build a deck around. Now, looking in this pack, you can see we've got Control Magic was not that bad. We just have Oracle of Moldiah, which is pretty reasonable, especially with shuffle effects. Survival and that sort of stuff. And then we have some fatties. We have Iona, Bogart, and Hellkite. Pretty good in reanimator decks. Or something with like a sneak attack deck, like the one that we ended up passing earlier. Overall, I'm more of a fan of Oracle than Control Magic, just because I like being able to play very proactively with my green decks. And Oracle is definitely one of those cards that lets you do that. Whereas Control Magic is, I mean, it's decent, but a lot of times it won't be nearly as good as something that lets you just sort of ignore the opponent. So we're gonna go ahead and take the Oracle. Now here you can see we've got a few more green cards. You can see Lotus Cobra and Stronger Root Geist, and then you also see some lands. And a lot of black cards, so it would seem like black and green are definitely open, whereas the other colors are sort of it's undetermined right now. And Raging Ravine is not that bad. Then we also have Godless Shrine, which is pretty good with the cycle of fetch lands. Really lets you play off-color fetch lands to fix your mana very well. Overall, I think Lotus Cover is going to end up being the best green option. I generally am not a fan of Sternal Rootgeist just because it's a little bit too aggro for me, and I don't really like going aggro with green decks. I just prefer to go over the top. So we're going to go ahead and take this Lotus Cover, and keep in mind that we've got a bunch of black cards, so if we see some more black cards, we might want to just go into green block. Now here you can see we have a Troll Ascetic. Troll Ascetic really isn't that great just because it's like a sort of dorky creature. I much prefer Explore. Works well with Lotus Cobra, works well with Oracle Moldiah, and generally just have a lot of synergy with that. There's also Braids, which is pretty sick on turn 3, especially when you're on the play. It's like an Armageddon on wheels at that point. But other cards, Legacy's Lure is pretty sweet, but I think we're just going to go ahead and take this Explore for now. You can see there's some more blue cards. I definitely would not mind being blue. Blue is one of my favorite colors, surprisingly. Now here we've got Borderland Ranger, we've got City of Brass. I'm not really too much of a fan of Old Man of the Sea. just because he's it's pretty easy to go over the top of him. But you also have Scrublin, some Petal Growth, definitely some man. I definitely have a bit of mana fixing. I think I'm just going to go with the Borderland Ranger, even though he's pretty underpowered. It's not really clear where we're going at this point. So, Borderland Ranger is going to Borderland Ranger is going to make it so that we can pick whatever second color we want to go into without too much of a hassle. Now here you can see we have Exploration. Exploration is actually pretty sick with stuff like draw 7 effects and Heartbeat of Spring and that sort of stuff. But overall, it's going to be difficult to utilize. Looking at the rest of the pack, we have Oblivion Stone, we have a Behemoth Sledge. Behemoth Sledge is decent in the mid-range mirrors just because you're generally trading up and you're gaining life, so it's pretty hard to race against that. I think I'm going to go with Exploration. I like this sort of turbo land theme, and Exploration sort of plays pretty well into that. This is pretty good. Boreal Druid. Definitely one of the worst of the one-drop mana accelerants, just because it adds colorless mana to your pool. So it's at the very, very bottom of one-drop creatures that I'd want to see or play, but it's the first one that we've seen, so I'll definitely be happy to take it. And there we go. All right. Next pick, you can see some of the black cards wield. Student Warfare, Kami of Ancient Law. Yeah, I think that black is open and to some extent blue is. And out of all these cards, I'm more of a fan of Seagate Oracle just because I dislike black a lot. There's a lot of sort of mid-range creatures and some various removal spells, but it's really difficult to go over to the top of black, so I'm going to go ahead and take this Seagate Oracle. And here I think we want to take Flooded Grove. It's a pretty good mana fixing for blue-green just because you end up having a lot of blue spells with double blue in the cost, so as you can see now with the all the cards we have, I mean, we were taking green cards over everything, most other options, but generally when you end up playing a green-blue deck, you have a lot of forests in your deck, so it's pretty difficult to make double blue. And Flooded Grove does that pretty well. Here we can take Smith Growth Chamber. Both of the green fatties wield, or both of the big creatures wield. And we still have that Survival of the Fittest, so you have to keep in mind reanimation strategies. So if we end up seeing something like Diabolic Servitude, then we may want to consider to start picking up large creatures. But Simic Growth Draper is going to be the pick for us. And here we can take either the Blood Gift Demon, or we can go ahead and take Godless Shrine. Or Godless Shrine is going to be better just because it's you can fetch it. Whereas the Arcane Sanctum is less useful. Now here, I think we want to go with Braids, just because it's pretty easy to get disenchant effects, and if we end up going into black instead of blue, then it's going to be pretty good to have Braids, especially with all of this mana acceleration. And we'll just take a Blake Sliver and a last pick, Titanic Pact. So I guess this Seagate Oracle may have been just a blip. I thought that there would be more blue cards coming around after it, but I guess not. Here, I think we want to go ahead and take Recurring Nightmare. It's really good with survival, and especially with one drops, because you just start demonic tutoring, basically. Other options would include there's a pair of fetch lands, keep in mind. Don't really like Tarmogoyf in the cube just because it's generally more of a mid-rangey creature, which, like as I've mentioned a few times before, is just not what I want to do with green decks. I just want to go over the top. I want to do stuff like Recurring Nightmare or Survival of the Fittest, that sort of over the top. There's also a Force of Will, but at this point I'm going to just exclude blue from this point. So there we have Recurring Nightmare. And now we have a few cards. Let's see. There are no very, very large creatures, but we do have a Rampant Growth. And there's also a Wooded Foothills, which the only dual lands we have right now is Godless Shrines. And there's also a Taiga, so those don't really overlap too well. Show and Tell may end up working out, but I think we're just going to go ahead and take the Rampant Growth. There's nothing really too interesting, so let's go ahead and hope that we this is Rampant Growth will help us with fixing our mana. And here you can see we have Pristine Talisman, which is not that great just because it's expensive, and so you're not really getting too much of a mana boost. Alternatively, there's Black Sun Zenith, but that really doesn't combo too well with stuff like Boreal Druid and Lotus Cobra. And I think the best card for us is going to be Doomblade or Eureka, but Eureka gets pretty bad with a bunch of mana acceleration, so I think it's going to be the Doomblade for us, and we can end up running a few removal spells. It's also balanced, but like I said before, when you have a ton of creatures that are accelerating you out, it ends up not being the best because you just have to end up sacrificing all those. So go ahead and take this Doomblade. Now this could be pretty interesting. Scavenging is not really interested in that. It's going to be good against us, but what I want to do is take either Buried Alive and Necromancy and then hopefully wheel the other. Necromancy is going to be better with if we have Survival, whereas Buried Alive is going to be better if we have Current Nightmare. I think Necromancy is just going to be better overall just because you can take one of your opponent's creatures. So, I mean, Buried Alive is better off when you have big creatures of your own, but with Necromancy you can play it almost at any time, so I'm going to take that. This pack is pretty mediocre. There's basically just Indric Stompowler because you don't want to play Corrupt. And that's about it. Yeah. At this point, I'm just excluding white. So Indric Stompowler is the only creature, the only card that we'll end up playing. And it's fine. Usually there are a few targets in a lot of decks, so having a random disenchant that also doubles as a body is not that bad. And here, I think we're going to go with Thran Dynamo. One of the problems with a lot of reanimator decks is sometimes they actually can't cast their fatties. But with Thran Dynamo, a lot of mana acceleration, that you can end up casting them with not too much difficulty. So we'll go and snatch that one up. I think we're going to go ahead and try to run this Armageddon also. And I don't think we'll be able to fit in the Seagate Oracle, unfortunately. There's also Fertile Ground, so if we go ahead and hide this guy and the cost sort, we've got Explore, Rampant Growth, Lotus Cobra at 2, so I'm definitely happy you're taking the Dynamo. Yeah, this is pretty good. I really like Ulamog, but unfortunately, we're not going to be able to reanimate it with very much ease, although we can use Survival of the Fittest, Survival of the Way, and then with the trigger on the stack, play Necromancy as an instant. So we get to hit him for 10 and then Annihilate 4. But I'm just going to go with the Evanescence Pilgrim. It's more consistent, fixes Armageddon for us, and I'm not going to say that we're going to wheel this guy, because chances are not, but we might wheel this Brushland, which I'll be happy. Now, here we're going to take Lanaworld, I think. Just because more one drop acceleration, good with Survival of the Fittest, good with Recurring Nightmare, whereas Hypnotic Spectre is just a dork. I mean, it's fine, but it's just a dork, and I would rather have the acceleration. It plays much better overall. And here we have the option of taking, I think it's going to be Ancient Tomb or Bane of the Living. And I like Ancient Tomb more, just because Bane of the Living kills all of our dudes, whereas Ancient Tomb can accelerate us into better broken plays. And here there's Yeva can be okay. Restock is generally pretty mediocre. So I think I'm going to go with restock just because it is pretty dorky. I don't see the appeal of running these sort of mid-rangey creatures. I'd rather get back something like Doomblade or Recurring Nightmare if it gets tossed away. And there we've got, I'm going to have Smother as a sideboard card. I'm pretty happy with just the Doomblade though. And there's also Eureka, but we don't have any fatties, so I'm just going to take this Pristine Talisman. There's also Balance, which we could, it could give us the line of discarding big creatures, which is actually kind of appealing. And then this Pristine Talisman really isn't that great, so that's going to be pretty interesting, I think. Now here we can take either Chalcedon or a Merry Angel. I'm more of a fan of a Merry Angel, and the Chalcedon is not something that we're going to, I mean, it's unlikely that we're going to be able to cast either, but if we do end up reanimating one, then a Merry Angel is going to be better. And I suppose we can take this Corrupt just in case, but we're probably going to be hiding it. Ooh, Life Pain Zombie versus Fertile Ground. I'm more of a Fertile Ground person, just because playing against green creatures is not likely. So that one guy that's playing white, I mean, as you saw earlier, there's a ton of white coming late, so